All right, so that's about commit and rollback. So what exactly is SAVEPOINT? SAVEPOINT is for people to save their data. Okay, I mean, that's not the exact meaning. See, while working in a data sheet like this big, you have so many insert statement. Now you don't know where exactly you want to commit or roll back. So what you can do is you can save some area as a pointer. Okay, this will confuse you guys. Let's take you have some statements, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So these are your SQL statements, right? In Notepad, if I highlight these lines like this, it makes easy, right, to read the data. The same happens with SAVEPOINT. You actually save your data into a variable, or you actually tell SQL that this is one checkpoint. So what is a checkpoint? It's a referential area. So what you can do is, we will look at one example and then you will understand what exactly is SAVEPOINT rather than me saying much about it. So what should I do? Shall we delete all this? Okay, I'm trying to delete everything. Okay, everything is deleted. So what we'll do is select star from books underscore one. Let us run this query. Okay, I see that there is one record into this one, right? So let me insert a record, insert into books underscore one values 2 comma XYZ comma business. Let me run this command. Okay, ooh, it's a semicolon. Row is inserted. So I don't know whether I want to issue a commit right now or I want to issue a rollback. I'm not sure about it. What I'll do is I can use SAVEPOINT command. SAVEPOINT first. Okay. After this, what I can do is I can insert a couple of more records into the table. I'll do it quickly, guys, just to save time. And this is done. This is 4. This is record 5. And then what I'm doing is SAVEPOINT second. And I'll insert one more record now. You can use anything like update, delete, or whatever the statement says. This will be 6, right? So let me run these inserts. And I think we'll have to run this one also, SAVEPOINT first. And then, okay, we were supposed to run the SAVEPOINT before this one. So let me insert this and run the SAVEPOINT second. So what SAVEPOINT allows you to do is you can quickly commit or roll back to a SAVEPOINT, right? So for example, roll back to SAVEPOINT first. So what happens is till this SAVEPOINT and after this SAVEPOINT, whatever commands you have run, they become invalid. So it's kind of a simple way that helps you to roll back or quickly commit the data till whatever point you want. So let's take, you made a mistake in these inserts. So what you can do is you can roll back to SAVEPOINT first. That means you will jump over here and then issue a commit. So that way, all these transactions that you issued after the SAVEPOINT first, these all will become invalid or they all will be rolled back. So that's the beauty of SAVEPOINT. You can create checkpoints in between your work so that it's easy to commit or roll back to a perfect SAVEPOINT.